I'm going to show you the basics of building the campground dashboard that we currently have on the screen. You will see that they're easy to build. The way that you lay things out is the same as in PowerPoint, which you already know how to use. Now, let's do something a bit prettier and get a better understanding of Displayr and survey data. This time, we're going to pull in some raw data from a survey about campsites and build a beautiful interactive dashboard. Let's import the dataset. This one is an SPSS data file, but you can import from Excel or pretty much anything else. When we import the data, Displayr shows the data on the left. We can create tables by dragging it across like so. Because Displayr is designed for surveys, it immediately recognizes grids like this. Let's start by creating a top two box score. Next, let's import the background image. As you can see, this image is the wrong size, so we will need to resize it. See these red lines which appear as I'm resizing my image? The great thing about Displayr is it has built-in guides which let you know where your image is relative to your canvas, so you can resize and reposition images easily and neatly. Let's just move the table off to the side for now. We'll come back to it later. Let's start by putting in a traffic light system showing performance of the different areas in the campsite. Let's hook this up to the table. We will link it up to show the first row of data that is satisfied. So in this case, store overall. We can resize this circle by dragging and dropping, but with things like this, which are more intricate, it can be easier to have more micro control. So we're going to resize and move the shape around using the panel on the right. Let's set this up as a traffic light system, so that when the values change, it updates. Now we can copy and paste this to reuse it for the rest of the chart. So I'm going to duplicate it all first. I'm not getting the position of these circles quite right with my cursor, so I'm going to use the panel on the right again to make them fit cleanly. But since we already did that earlier, I won't bore you too much and we'll just skip ahead a little bit. Now that they're in place, let's hook them up to the right values. I'm sure you get the idea. Usually the dashboard has more going on than this, so I'm just going to put in some shapes as placeholders. Here's some I prepared earlier. Now it's time to create some filters. Easy. Remember that table that we moved to the side earlier? We have to hide it so that it won't show up on our published dashboard. So just select it and press Hide. Let's publish this as a dashboard. Since we have a single page, we can hide the navigation pane so that when we publish it, the dashboard will be nice and simple, without any unnecessary distractions. Remember, it's also interactive. Focus your attention on the score for store, which is currently orange. Let's filter this by location. Let's say Pretty Beach. We see Pretty Beach has a much better score for store. As you can see, it took us just a few minutes to get this going. The hard part isn't so much getting it working, it's more figuring out how to make it beautiful. Our designers can help with this as well if you need. Now, if this is the type of analyzing and reporting that you want to do, then book a demo with one of our experienced researchers today. We'll tailor the demo exclusively for you. Just pick a time that works for you, and you'll have your very own free session with a Displayr expert.